And how do you feel about the sound on your debut?
Well, it's funny. It was a riot. It was a roller coaster, really. So we made this album in this crazy house with tea and bacon sandwiches, and it was a garage record. It sounded like something from the 70s in New York. It was like, you know, but acoustic. It was quite acoustic. It wasn't electric. So, but it really was incredibly raw. And that's what Steve and I were trying to do, was really kind of break out of this idea that, you know, a girl with a guitar needs to be this polite, you know, nice thing. Mm-hmm. And I had no idea about the record-making process. No one had ever sat down and said, well, what happens is you do pre-production where you work out what you want to sound like, and then you do the recording session, which is going to take a few weeks, and then you're going to do overdubs, which means that you'll add stuff to what you've already recording, and then you go into mixing, which can completely change the sound of your record, and then you'll go into mastering, which can also have a massive effect. No one told me any of that, and I had no idea. I thought you just go in the studio and they record what you do and that's that. And so we'd finished this record. I was really excited about the mixes. And I was not invited to the mix of my record. I didn't even know it was happening. I got the record kind of returned to me, not knowing that the master had been sent to someone somewhere. And to my ears, it was like someone had just put it on an ironing board and just completely flattened what I'd made. And I was gutted. And I've not really spoken about this very much because it was really hard for many years to talk about struggling with the record because it was so popular. Mm. So when it came out, people just loved it. And thank you. And so it was going to be completely counterproductive for me to go out and sit and talk to people, go, oh, hate it. What's the point of that? Do you know what I mean? Yeah. It's useless. It's a useless thing to be saying, where I am proud of the record. But it's interesting now to go back and actually look at that. And it wasn't nearly as bad as I thought, actually. And when I listen to it now, it sounds great. It still sounds really raw. I'm like, geez, what did it sound like? Because it sounds pretty raw still now, but I remember it very well. It was a Time Out interview with a journalist called John Lewis, and he was asking me, he said, so, you know, you basically, I was listening to Other Side of the World, you basically sound like Dido. And I just lost it. Yeah, I was very rude, and I've apologized since, but it really belittled what, and I mean, Dido's an amazing artist. She's, you know, hugely popular. Yeah. She's made very significant music that's been the soundtrack to people's lives at a certain time. But for me, it's studio music. It's not really a live, sound. Mm. And that was what I massively prided myself on and had spent a decade perfecting, was being a great live act. And so that really pissed me off. And it just absolutely tapped into that pain that I'd felt by not having control over how the record had sounded. And it's interesting too, because there's always been a conflict for me becoming famous for these very, very positive pop songs. And even though they still sound pretty raw, they don't totally represent what feels like my middle point. They're definitely at the poppier side of what I do. And I, listen, there's no regrets. And I could not be more grateful that I've got these two babies that went out into the world and are still out there roaming around and just opening doors for me and giving me an amazing life. And a lot of joy as well. But, you know, there's definitely been struggles over the years to try and represent the darker side of what I do, or the more rocky side of what I do. I've always felt like, I remember when I was a kid and we would go camping in France and we went to the Pyrenees, and there was a place where you could stand with one foot in Italy and one foot in Spain. And I've always felt like that with like indie rock and pop. and my hits are on the pop side, and the other half of me is always over here going, but what about, but I, but maybe that's good. Maybe it's good to have that conflict and have that push and pull and be able to straddle and do, you know, it's great. I've always loved trying different things and doing different things. And hey, it's just having hits is an amazing thing.